According to the leaders, trees in the forest were cut down by illegal loggers with the support of National Forest Authority officials.
Forest Authority have been, the staff have been participating in the illegal activities in that forest. Most of the timbers which were cut down, I mean the trees which were cut down into timbers, were being supported. Those people are being supported by NFAP.
That the seasons in Bunyoro, in some 50 years back, the season was not like this. We used to have reliable rainfalls because of the two forest blocks, that is Bugoma and Budongo. But today we had reached an extent of having no rain during planting seasons.
The chairperson LC5 Hoima District, Kadeo Karunji, says animals have been dying due to lack of water and others killed by people because of eating their crops. He adds that this is putting Uganda's wildlife conservation at stake.
Who's killing of animals, of those animals and the chimpanzees and the rest? They have been attacked seriously. Why? Because they used to hide themselves under trees and they used to enjoy fruits from those trees. Now the trees are not there. They had to cross into the gardens of different peoples and they were being hunted seriously.
Due to this, they have decided to pass a resolution for the two central forest reserves to be taken over by Uganda Wildlife Authority from National Forest Authority for better protection.
The intervention of government so far to take care, to upgrade those forest reserves into Wildlife Authority. Because as I'm speaking, we are calling them forestry. But in actual sense, they are not forests. It is land, because most of the trees were put down.
When that National Forest Authority, in its approaches to conservation, has been having a lot of laxity, and during this laxity, we have lost very many forest reserves. Some of them have been turned from natural forests to plantation forests.
Leon Chandia, the principal wildlife officer in the Ministry of Tourism, says the ministry is reforming the wildlife protected areas plan.
We are reforming the wildlife protected areas systems plan. And one of the reasons we are making these changes, it is because of the threats that these areas are facing. The threats are faced by some of our game reserves, including the central forest reserves we have targeted.
Chandia explains that they did a scientific study between 2017 and 2018 before making the change, and they are now asking local governments to endorse the taking over of all central forest reserves from NFA to Uganda Wildlife Authority for better protection.
It's just one of the steps. We told you that to make these changes, we first do a scientific study, which we did between 2007 and 2018. We concluded that study, but now is the stage where you ask the leaders to give their endorsement. So the district leaders have given their endorsement, and we should be able to use these resolutions to take our proposal to cabinet.
Chandia has requested people to protect wildlife because they are a source of income to the country.
The issue is not that government does not want its own people. No government can do that. The issue is that the animals cannot develop, they cannot defend themselves. If government does not step in to defend this wildlife, we shall all finish them. They will all be killed. And when these ones are killed, we are the ones who start suffering, because the animals are our resource. They give us money.
According to research made by Global Forest Watch from 2002 to 2021, Uganda lost 71.6 million acres of humidity primary forest, making up to 7.6% of its total tree cover loss in the same time period. Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomoza for the news.